Welcome to the first stage of this character creation process. We're going to do some modeling, and I need to give you guys a little bit of a heads up about what to expect. First, there are two different types of modeling techniques. One is the traditional method, where you start from a low poly mesh, okay, and then you create a high poly mesh, and then bake the normals on top of that. The newer method, and this is probably preferable today, is the retopology workflow. Now, the retopology workflow starts with a high poly mesh, and then you move on to the low poly mesh. Okay, so you start with the high poly sculpt, then you manually create a low poly mesh on top of that. That way you can easily bake the normals, the normal maps on the high poly mesh onto the low poly mesh. So it's a very slightly different little technique, but you may be asking yourself, well, what's the point of that? Because it seems like you're just flipping these two techniques around. Well, the first reason is because most artists, generally speaking, they don't have a lot of experience in rigging and texturing. So what they do is they do a high poly sculpt so that they can get the look of the character right first. And once that looks right, then they can create a low poly mesh on top of that. It's just more accurate, it's faster, and it allows the artist to focus only on the look of the character. In our case, we're only going to go for the traditional workflow. And you might be asking, well, why can't we do the retopology workflow? Well, the reason is because if you're just starting to learn 3D, it's a good idea to learn the fundamentals first. So traditional workflow, it goes through all the basic fundamentals. It might be a bit slower, but once you get these principles in your head, you don't have to worry about, you know, how to model using the retopology workflow. So in essence, we're kind of learning two things at the same time. So that's what we're going to be focusing on, okay? Just the traditional workflow. The other thing I also want to mention is your motivation during the rest of this course. And I think it's a good idea to briefly go through that. And this is going to represent your motivation during this process. So I'll put a 50% mark here. So this is the 50% completion of the course. And then you have the 25 and 75%. So your motivation is going to start like this, okay? You're gonna be super excited to start and you're like, oh, okay, cool. And then there's just gonna be this nasty, nasty dip down around the 50% mark. Now this is the danger zone, I would like to call it, because this is where most people quit. Now I find that when you quit at the 50% mark, it's very understandable. I've gone through that many times myself, and even today, I still suffer through this, you know, halfway point barrier. So that's why in the introduction video, I did mention that you should have about maybe $100 cash, just disposable cash for this entire process. And what I usually do, and this is going to vary between people, is I put checkpoints at each step of the process. So around the 50% mark, this is where I kind of lose a lot of motivation and get seriously bored of this project and I just want to quit. So what I do is at the end of each of the stages from the 50% mark, I probably put in maybe $25 to buy myself like a nice dinner, okay? Or pizza, if that's what you love, or maybe even movies. Whoops. Just something to treat yourself, okay? It gives you a little bit of that extra kick to help you push through this little danger zone right here. And the great news is, after you've gotten past the 50% mark, your motivation should steadily go back up again. This is a horrible curve, but at least you kind of get the point. And around here, I probably put maybe another $25 reward. And depending on how motivated you are, I might just draw an arrow here. I might make another $25 reward here at the end process. So treat yourself to whatever it is it may be. I don't know, it could be, you know, movies, dinner, or something. Just something to help reward you and keep your brain associating this process as a good thing, okay? What about the other $25? Well, $100, we've got extra 25 bucks. The other $25 is mainly used for concept art, and I'm going to show you guys that in a second, but you're going to need help from other people, generally speaking. So concept art, and this is more relevant to those who want to create their own personal character. So you're going to need a designer to do this for you. You can find them at DeviantArt.com Or you can also go to conceptart.org. So either one of these two websites will help. These are just art communities, they're forums. You can go and ask and spend $25 and get somebody to draw some concept art for you. Okay, maybe it's a character that you want to create for yourself. Or you can use the character sheet that I have included inside this course. So this is the character sheet of the rusher. I've commissioned an artist to do this for me, okay, because my drawing skills are not that great. What I have asked for is a side view, okay, and a front shot. So profile and front view of this character. So traditional methods require you to have these character sheets in your scene. It just makes things a lot easier for you. And then we have some poses of our character right here, okay. We've also got some facial expressions. And these are relevant to facial rigging, because when we get to the facial rigging aspect, we need to see how the face is going to deform, okay? We need some references. There are other bits and pieces, for example, the feet, okay? And generally speaking, you also want the hands and maybe pieces of the armor as well, but we can work with this, okay? It's totally fine. And of course, we've also got just a final render or painted picture of the character itself. And this is very important when it comes to the texturing stage of our process. So a character sheet is very important. You actually need one. If you don't have one and you want to create your own custom character, go ahead to these websites right here and ask around, okay? That's what the extra $25 is for. Or you can spend a little bit more if that's what you want. It's completely up to you. Doesn't cost much, and it's a very valuable asset to this process. So don't underestimate that. Okay, so with that done, I'm going to bring this concept sheet into Maya and we're going to begin our modeling process. So I'll see you guys there.